opposite effect. It would likely displace the currents, exacerbating the humanitarian situation, and then creating an environment for increased conflict that would probably result in more, not less, military force. I think it's also important to recognize that the safe zone would disrupt the most effective force against ISIS, which is the Syrian Democratic Forces, of which the Kurdish component of it is the YPG, and they are critical to that. I think it's also important that everybody recognize that the Syrian Democratic Forces, the YPG included with them, performed the singularly unique task of safeguarding thousands of captured ISIS fighters and family members. No one else is doing this. So implementing a safe zone puts that at risk.
How far is that exacerbated potentially by the drawdown in the number of U.S. troops?
Well, I think, you know, in order to do that, there certainly would need to be some element of U.S. or coalition forces on the ground to help implement that. But there's other things that can be done. There can be some joint patrols, and there can be some observation posts in place. There can be aerial.
Deborah was beginning to think maybe she'd
made the rest of the